Hello and welcome to the 4th annual Star Wars Art Show here in Houston, Texas. I'm Mark Rodriguez and today we'll be covering all the art today, all the activities, all the fun we're having right now at the Star Wars Art Show. So stay tuned for more, all right? May the Force be with you. With Stephanie. What's up?
I'm right in front of the DJ booth, so I'm having a great time.
Yeah. That's awesome. Yeah, it's all about
Star Wars inspired. Everything's really cool right now. I have not been a part of this show, and I have known Dandy for so long, so this year I decided to be a part of it. I made some mugs, some shirts. It's been great. There's so much amazing artwork everywhere. The music's great, so I encourage people to come out and check it out.
Cool. So how long have you been doing art, period?
I've been making art since I was 13, but I recently started working full-time as an artist this year. So,
all right, congratulations.
So I'm pretty happy, yeah.
Yeah, nice. I like the simplicity, but there's beauty in simplicity, you know, I always love that. So,
When I designed the shirts, I try to keep it minimal. And it was all done on Illustrator, but I wanted to keep it minimal and, you know, just a little touch of something.
So are you a big Star Wars fan, or are you just contributing to the art show right now?
I'm just contributing to the art show and really kind of supporting my friend who's throwing it. I can't say that I'm the biggest fan, but I'm definitely a fan of what Star Wars is and what, you know, the message behind the whole movie, and it brings people together, so it's pretty, I'm just glad to be a part of it, but I'm not like a huge fan. I'm really trying to like contribute my, you know, a little touch of my work into the show because I feel like there's so much variety, so.
Yeah, I'm a huge Star Wars fan, but you know, when you think about the making of Star Wars and how many artists had to contribute to make the visual. So, you know, without art, there would be no Star Wars, you know? So I'm a big fan of artists. And even though you're not a big fan of Star Wars, I appreciate what you're doing and how you're doing it. So that's cool. So let us know about any further projects that you have.
Right now I'm working on a commission for a new restaurant lounge that's gonna be opening up on Main Street. I just got back from Saigon. I did art for a 5-star hotel. So like stuff is happening. So I don't know the name of this bar yet, but it's gonna be on Main Street. And it's a new bar, it's got a geisha. I've been painting geishas on the wall. So I'm working on it with Julie Warsham, who's my business partner. So that's what I got going on right now. And I have a solo show coming up on the 29th of May. Yeah.
Well, awesome. Thanks for all your time and thanks for coming out.
All right, thanks for interviewing me, I guess. Thanks for being out here supporting.
Awesome. Okay, we'll get right back with more. Thank you. are with Alex, artist Alex. I don't have a last name right now.
Ramos. But
Alex Ramos. Man, first of all, I want to say this guy's sculptures are out of this world. So much detail. I don't know how much they're going for, but I would guess tens of thousands of dollars. And I would pay it if I had it. So Alex, what is your passion in art? Where does it all start?
Dude, I'm all over the place, man. Like, honestly, I do paintings, drawings, sculptures now. This is actually really recent, about a year now that I've been doing this kind of work. It's called assemblage, or it's a French word, assemblage. Putting things together that don't belong and then creating something beautiful. I take a lot of my inspiration from religion. I was born and raised Catholic, so a lot of my work really has a lot of religious overtone and a lot of like meaning behind it. Kind of how we idolize physical things and we create altars to false gods, you know, so.
Right, yeah, I know in the Catholic religion and Dias de Muertos, altars are a big deal, but you're so intricate and detailed. Is that just part of your personality?
Yeah, a little bit, man. I'm kind of like, I'm really intense. I get real detailed with things. I'm never settled. They're not finished. They're never finished, so, yeah.
Awesome. So let's talk about the black piece first. What is the theme of the black piece?
So actually, they're pieces that are supposed to be together, right? It's the dark and the light. It kind of tells a story, right? On the left shows the battle that Darth Vader had to go through when he was like Darth, right? He was an evil. Just kind of, you're seeing all the epic battles. There's a lot of little things going on the inside. You can actually see where there at the bottom, there's a hand coming out. It's supposed to represent the Force guiding Luke in his X-Wing. That one, I mean, it's supposed to represent like this this piece where you're like praising this darkness, you know? So the one on the right is supposed to be after he kind of redeemed himself, you know, by sacrificing himself for his son. And that shows how he's ascended. He's no longer a Sith. He's now a Jedi again. So the right one is him as Saint Vader.
Awesome, man. I just get chills just looking at him. So detailed. So how many different pieces, say, go into one artwork like that?
Dude, thousands of little intricate pieces. The crazy thing is, I never have an idea of what it's going to look like at the end. I always just end up like working through the night. The one on the left, I'm clocking out about 180 hours worth of solid work. And just like putting things together, gluing things. There, at one point, I tore it apart. Took it completely apart and then put it back together because it didn't look right. So, yeah.
Wow. That's wild. I just can't imagine. So what can we expect from you in the future? What else are you getting into?
So it's funny because I'm a geek, man. Geek at heart. I love comic books. I love anything sci-fi. So I'm actually leaning towards doing a piece surrounding Marvel, right? So doing some really epic battle with a bunch of figures from a lot of the Marvel world. The Hulk, Iron Man, Thor, like all of that. So yeah.
Great, man. I would love to get together and do like a mini documentary on your work. So something we can get together on later. All right. Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you too, brother. Thank you.
All right, stay tuned for more from the annual Star Wars Art Show. We'll be right back. All right, here we are with Zoltan from
Hungary, Budapest.
From Hungary, Budapest, all the way from Hungary, Budapest, here in Houston, Texas, at the 4th Annual Star Wars Art Show. Big fan, man, of Star Wars myself, and a big fan of your art now, especially the one we just zoomed in on with Princess Leia and Luke. It's awesome. So how long have you been a Star Wars fan?
Well, probably since I was a little child, like, you know, like 13, 14 years, something like that. So quite long.
Yeah, so what makes you come all the way to Houston, Texas from your hometown?
Well, first of all, I love Texas, I love Houston, I love Star Wars, and I love art mainly, and my girlfriend.
Your main love is here.
Yeah, she's here, yeah.
All right. Well, big up to Love for bringing our artist friend here to Houston to show us his incredible art. Who's your favorite Star Wars character?
I would say Jabba.
Jabba? Why Jabba?
He's laid back. He's eating enough. You know, he's doing good.
He's a boss. He's a boss.
He is.
Okay. So what else? Let's talk about this piece right here. What was the idea behind this piece?
Okay, so this is from my friend. Actually, we are all from the Epic Inc. crew. It's our moving art gallery. So he's my team member. Actually, you should ask him about this, but unfortunately, he couldn't make it. He's still in Hungary, Budapest, but he's only doing black and white pieces. And, you know, he just mainly, he loves black and white, and mainly faces, so portraits. So that's it.
Cool. So what's the idea behind the whole crew, artist crew thing?
Well, we know each other for like 10 years at least, and everybody's doing street art, graffiti, or gallery, or whatever, and we just figured since we are always doing, you know, stuff together, like, why not to form a crew, like, you know, a team, and do things together. I mean, you know, it's we are more productive in that way, and you know, we inspire each other, so, you know.
Yeah, awesome. I mean, graffiti is big here in Houston as well. It's a big graffiti scene, yeah, and we... Yeah, we understand the idea of the crew concept. So what was the name of the crew again?
It's Epic, Epic Inc.
Epic Crew, okay. And what do you feel that street, where's street art going in the future?
I hope it's moving up, going up, and, you know, getting more and more popular around the world. I mean, you know, I like the, like, really the not just the gallery and the art stuff, but I also like the wall pieces, the mural pieces. That's what I like to do. But, you know, it's also a nice thing to move, like, graffiti artists into galleries and then nice, huge exhibitions like this. Like, I mean, it's really good. It's a good feeling to you know, come inside from the street. Like,
yeah, very cool. So, are you a spray aerosol guy or wheat paste, or what style do you use?
I'm actually making like mixed technique. Originally I'm doing you know, graffiti, like paint spray paint things, but I also do canvases with brush and pencils and all kinds of different techniques, like just what I can, you know, grab and, you know, do some art with, so whatever it is.
Very cool. Well, here we are with Zoltan. So we're here with the curator, Dandy Warhol, of this fourth annual Star Wars art show. Dandy, how do you do it, man?
Well, we've been doing this for like 5 years, so it's kind of like, you know, we're kind of used to it, but we don't expect it to get bigger and bigger every year. We're just prepared mentally, you know, trying to get work as done as we can before the show and just like manage like the people. So we're kind of used to, you know, doing stuff like this, so, you know.
It's a big event, really. I mean, he's being really humble about it. It's huge. I know y'all had a couple of thousand last year. Y'all still counting numbers, I'm sure, right now. Yeah. We're just getting started. It's still early here. I've walked through most of it, and I'm blown away. I'm nerded out already. I love it. I've felt so bad that I missed the past ones.
Yeah, yeah.
But so what's your passion with Star Wars?
Well, you know, I used to own a gallery, so we're throwing shows, like, every month. And we're trying to fill a date for a May date, and a friend of mine, Kat Dominguez, she suggested, hey, that's Star Wars Day. You should, you know, try it out, see how it goes. And then we tried it out. Tons of people showed up, and we're like, well, we have to do it again next year, you know? And then a year after that, it just gets bigger and bigger. So now it's like pretty much like we have to do it now, but we love doing it. So it gets a lot of artists involved, a lot of community involved. So, and it's kid-friendly, so family people will be coming here and enjoying the view.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. I have to tell you, man, I really appreciate the effort you put towards all the artwork for the city.
Yeah.
And you're a big name here in Houston, and we love the idea. So let us know about further projects that you have going on.
Well, I work at a school, so we're throwing our annual art show at the Sugarland Children's Museum. And then after that, we're going to be working with the Texas Children's, doing a mural and talking with the kids. So we've got some projects coming up, keeping me busy.
All right, very cool. So one last thing, who's your favorite Star Wars character?
Man, you can't go wrong with Vader, man. He's just so cool. Gotta be Vader.
No doubt. All right, well, here we are with Dandy Warhol, the organizer of this event, and we're having a great time. Hi, this is Mark Rodriguez with HMSTV. We're out here at the Star Wars Art Show, and this is the fourth annual art show. It's a big deal. Thousands of people coming out from Houston to enjoy the Star Wars frenzy that we're having here. And right now we have Lady Vader, also known as Heather. Heather, so how's it going today?
It's going pretty awesome today. It's really awesome. A lot of cool pictures and artwork here, so I'm pretty excited.
All right, awesome. So how long have you been a Star Wars fan?
Oh, man. Probably since I was 8 or 9. I used to watch them with my dad, and just back and forth, know them all, and I'm ready for the new one to come out.
Awesome. Yeah, me too. We can't wait. Also, my cameraman, he's trying to give away spoilers, and I'm trying to...
Nah, keep the spoilers. Don't ruin them. Don't ruin spoilers.
Right, I'm trying to tell him, but he's cool. He stopped. So so why Vader? What's your obsession with Vader?
He's a bad guy, and I don't know. I just always thought he was the coolest one, and I love him.
Hot girls like bad guys. That's just the way it goes. You got to be a bad guy. Sorry, good guys. You know, I'm a good guy too sometimes, but you know, try to play bad a little bit in the beginning, then maybe turn into the good guy. They like that too. Okay. Well, thanks, Heather.
Thank you so much.
All right. Nice meeting you, and may the force be with you.
You too. Thank you. No spoilers.
And we'll be right back with more. We'll be right back. All right, we're back. Okay, flex. Okay, he's flexing. Get a zoom in on the shirt. All right. We're back at the Star Wars Art Show right here in Houston, Texas. We're here with artist, musician, and scientist. And
Renaissance man.
All Renaissance man out, yeah. Mr. Vincent Fink. So what brings you here today?
Star Wars, you know, and the love for the science fiction of space, you know, and all that great stuff. Yeah, just wanted to come out and see what it's all about. You know, it's been going on for a couple of years, and I'd never been a part of it yet. But every year I hear about how amazing it is. So, yeah, had to check it out.
Cool. I'm a big fan of your designs, all the geometry and sacred knowledge that's going on in those. So what helped made you fuse the two Star Wars and geometry together?
Well, me and Tina, we were trying to, you know, brainstorm about some ideas about what we could do to incorporate my geometry thing with the Star Wars thing in a nice way. And it was actually her idea. She had the idea of like, hey, you know, what if we had Yoda, you know, in his meditative pose, and we could have, you know, the platonic solids, which I've been putting in a lot of my designs, and have those kind of just circling around him. And as you can see, that's pretty much what we wound up with here. This is exactly what she imagined. Exactly what I imagined. So really happy when you know, our brains can kind of just come together and create something cool like that. You know,
it's an incredible design. One of my favorites. I'm gonna have to pull out the plastic and get one of these. Definitely love the shirt, man. So what else are you involved in right now? So let's go ahead and give yourself a little plug.
You know, just working on the summer line for .506. You know, this is actually probably gonna be part of it. We're thinking, you know, like we like it so much that we might continue printing this one for the rest of the summer. So I got to finish up with that. You know, we're going to have at least a couple more new designs and maybe some reissues. Other than that, just cranking out more paintings, you know, working on my iterations, the geometric surrealism, as well as I still need to finally finish the stage 4 of 4 in my Atlas Metamorphosis series, which was the first series that really kind of got me out there. And I've been kind of slacking. I really need to get on that. But, you know, I've just been so busy with so many other things. But it's good to be busy with all these things that that are inspiring to me, you know.
Cool, Vincent. So for everybody out there, you know, we're on the World Wide Web. If they want to get in contact with Vincent Fink, what do they have to punch in?
On the World Wide Web, just type in my name, Vincent Fink. It's VincentFink.com, and you will find my website. You can also check us out at .506.com. That's POINT 506 numerals.
Well, here I am, Mark Rodriguez, with Renaissance man Vincent Fink, and may the force be with y'all. All right, we're here with T.O.K. Talk, or a.k.a. this guy right here.
Yes.
Yeah. Man, I saw your stuff online.
I was blown away. I was like, this guy is really cool. I like his mixture of gore and Star Wars. So give us a little background on yourself.
Well, I used to be in the Army, and I was in the cavalry unit. And back in the day when the knights were on the cavalry, so I just picked up my name, being in the Army, Olive. So I'm the Olive Knight.
Oh, very cool, very cool. So how long have you been a Star Wars fan?
Probably since I was 2 when my mom took me to the first movie.
Awesome, awesome. So thanks, moms. Thanks to all the moms that take the guys to the movies, especially Star Wars. So what about gore? Where did your passion? Star Wars, there's a little gore in Star Wars, not too much. Where does that come into it all?
I like texture on artwork, and I like mixing beautiful and ugly together, and it always has a good composition to it.
Very smart. I like that, too. Awesome, man. Good contrast to things. So what else can you tell me about your passion for art?
Well, I grew up on doing comic illustration, and now I'm kind of doing fine art, so I'm just trying to push myself and see where I can take it and, you know, do all the cool stuff that there is to do.
Yeah, it seems like, you know, a lot of guys from our era, even before Star Wars, there was comic books, and that was the first love, and then Star Wars kind of kicked it up a notch. Oh, yeah. And then fine art definitely is the goal at the end. So what other styles do you have besides what we see here today?
Well, in these styles, I'm doing hand drawing with scanning them into the computer, and then I'm coloring on the computer. Sometimes I'll do painting with a little bit of ink action on it, and then other times I've dabbled a little bit of sculpting too.
Cool, man. Some sculptures? Cool. I'd like to see that one day. So you're a Houston native?
Yes, sir. Been in Houston for a while, except for the time I spent in the Army.
Okay, man. Well, that was talk. Thanks for all your help. Thanks for serving in the Army and taking care of us. And appreciate the artwork.
Thank you, sir.
We're back, and right now we have artist Omar. I walked by his booth just now. I was just stunned. There's some great prints, really awesome stuff. I found out he does all his own stuff, so here we are. Omar, we really like your stuff. How long have you been doing art?
I've been doing art my whole life, since I was 7. I mean, I started drawing when I was like 4, so I try to keep it up.
Cool. So is sci-fi a big part of your art world?
Oh, I mostly do original work. I don't do sci-fi as much, but I mean, there's a big feel in that. So, I mean, my brother is a fan of it, so I love to like please him by doing work that he likes, you know.
So, because of your brother, you kind of veer off and just to make him happy. Yeah. That's very cool. Some brotherly love there. So, tell us more about is this a wood printing or what kind of printing is this?
It's a variety. I'm taking a class. I'm going to school for pre-making, so I mean, I have a variety. I do silkscreen, I do etching, I do monotyping. I mean, I'm just like learning like all these techniques, and I'm putting them together as I go. Yeah.
It seems like you're a great student. You're catching along very well. What about Star Wars? Do you have any feel towards Star Wars, or is it just a theme for you today?
I lean towards the bad guys because, okay, you know, they bring that punch into the movie. It's just like, that's what I like. I mean, if there weren't bad guys, it just would be lame. I mean, like, right, who likes a good story? You know, like, you got to have a bad guy in there, you know?
So you're a Boba Fett fan?
Boba Fett and, like, Biker Scout, you know, whoever is, like, bad. You know, like, I want somebody to, like, take charge and, like, be blunt, you know? I don't want that fantasy stuff. You know?
So are you based out of Houston?
Yeah, I'm actually from Mexico, but I've been living here since I was 13. I'm 25 now.
Cool. So if anybody wants to reach out, because we're on the World Wide Web, and check out some more of your art, where would they go?
They can find me on Facebook. I have a page. It's Aware, A-W-R-E. Okay. And I have all my work, which is original. Like, this is like, I did this for the show, the Star Wars. You know, I don't really pose a lot of the stuff I have here. So, I mean, the best thing you can do is come out to the show, you know, enjoy it.
Right.
Cool, man. Appreciate it.
Thanks,
Zomar, Mark Rodriguez. We're going to be here at the Star Wars 4th Annual Art Show. Thanks to Dandy Warhol. Thanks, Dandy, for letting us come in, and we'll see you in a minute. All right, we're here with comic book artist Mark. Mark, so let us know why you're here today.
Well, I love Star Wars. I do a lot of Star Wars fan art, and I look forward to this show every year.
Okay, awesome. So how long have you been doing art?
Well, all my life. Mainly last 10 years, I started hitting conventions, pushing my comics and fan art. So roughly 10 years.
So what are your first memories of Star Wars?
I saw The Empire Strikes Back in May of 1980. I was not quite 4 years old. I remember every detail of the movie, going with my family. I remember going to see it again the second time and remembering I missed some things the first time, and it's very vivid, and I couldn't have been not even 4 years old. So it's a very vivid memory and kind of started me getting into art. I remember coming home on the floor in my living room and drawing AT-ATs with a... you know, on paper, crayons. And
wow, 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 awesome.
It goes way back, you know?
So are you Jedi or Sith?
Ask my girlfriend. I don't know. Maybe a Jedi, I guess.
All right, Jedi, cool. He's a good guy. So let's hear more about your comic books. I was checking out some of your covers here. They look pretty great, man. So what's the idea behind the comic books?
Well, I have two series. I have Land of the Rats. I also have Doom Ranch 5000. Land of the Rats is a sci-fi fantasy adventure on a different planet. It's kind of not quite Lord of the Rings. It's got some fantasy and sci-fi elements in it, and it's about a race of rat hybrid rat humans and their wars and their politics and their adventures. Mainly it's about one rat. His name's Jack Natari. He has, there's some other side characters that have adventures too, but right now it's really his story, and he wanders out of his homeland on a quest. So that's an ongoing series. Doom Ranch is an anthology I put together. I did the covers, I wrote the stories, but it's 12 stories done by different Texas artists. It's all ghost stories and supernatural myths, things we've all grown up listening to in Texas, that we've heard about the Chupacabra and different lesser-known supernatural stories. But it's mainly a way to get my friend's art out there and show other people's art and promote my friend's work.
Cool, awesome. All right, well, it's Jedi artist Mark and myself, Mark, and we're here at the annual Star Wars art show here in Houston, Texas, and stay tuned for more. Guys, hope you had as much fun as I did here at the Star Wars Art Show. Make sure to stay tuned to HMSTV, and we'll be back for more Star Wars next year. All right? May the Force be with you always.